What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Elbon coming back at y'all with a banger. In today's video, I'm about to be on the way to go get some new wheels. I just got out of class. It is hot as fuck. It's 101 degrees, but I'm on the way to get some wheels. They're about like an hour away and it's from a nigga off of Facebook Marketplace. So we're gonna go ahead and go do that one. All right, y'all, we just picked up some wheels from my boy Stefano. To you, Stefano, thank you. All right, let's make it back to the crib. All right, we're back at the crib with the new wheels, as you can see. These right here are the rears. They don't have any tires on them. And these right here are the fronts with tires on them. So the fronts are 18 by 9.5 plus 22. And this has a 245 35 18, kind of a big tire. And then the rears are 19 by 10.5 plus 22. So a lot of Genesis niggas have been running 10.5 in the rear and then 9.5 in the front. I'm a little bit scared to run this 10.5, mainly just because like it's a hella wide wheel. Like, look at this shit. Plus gens aren't like too wide like that in the rear. The fronts fit fine. I've already test fit those, and take a look at this. So I've gone ahead and thrown one of the 18 by 9.5 on the rear, and look at this fitment here. Yeah, there's no way that the 10.5 are gonna fit in the rear. There's just no way. I've jacked it up a little bit, and honestly, maybe a little spacer, but this is gonna be flush. So that's tough. I'm gonna get these 18 by 9.5 mounted, these tires mounted on there, and then I'm gonna test fit those, because I think if I can get these on here before I buy tires for these, it'll give me a good like generalization of what tire or what size I should buy for the rear. Because I don't think there's any way that this 10.5 is gonna fit. It's just way too wide. Not even that it's gonna poke out too much, but I don't think that these will be able to honestly clear the strut, because these are just so wide. So yeah, I'm gonna mount the 245s on the 18s and then see how that fits in the rear. And then off of that, I'll see what type of size I could get. I'm assuming I'm gonna need maybe a 19 by 9.5 and then put maybe a 255 or a 265 on there. Yeah, I feel like that's probably what's gonna work for this car. I don't know how people run 10.5 on the rear. That's a fucking huge wheel. But yeah, all right, this is the 10.5 on the rear. As you can see, yeah, I don't know. I don't think that's gonna really fit. This shit is wide as fuck. Dog. Yeah, this is like wide body type stance. Another thing is, barely clears the strut. There's literally that's the most I could do. So that's definitely an issue. Tough. All right, this might be the last time that the gen is on the Vision Boost. At least the front, the discount tire special, you feel me? Nah, they've been solid. They serve their purpose. So yeah, let's head over to the tire shop and get these on. All right, as you can see, the fronts are on, and I'm not even gonna lie, this shit looks amazing. Look at the fitment on this side. The fitment on this side is for sure better than that other side. As you can see, flush. That's nice. But if you come over here, well, if you look at this side, I don't necessarily know if it's because this side probably sits a little bit higher or if I maybe need to max out this camber plate, but as you can see, there's more poke on this side than there is the other side. So I'm hoping that if I max out the camber plate on this side, that the alignment will match up a little bit more. If not, I could put a little bit of a spacer on this side. I mean, I like how it's flush, but I do want it to be even. As you can see, sheesh, that's flush. I like that, that looks solid. So yeah, for the rears, I need to order some new ones for the rear or try and figure out how I'm gonna get these wheels to fit. I probably can't, probably gonna have to end up selling those and getting some new ones, but yeah, it looks solid. Maybe just lower the front a little. I'm not going low, I'm not slamming this for those of y'all who are like, slam it, go low, bro. Nah, I'm good. I like the comfortability of just not scraping and bottoming out and shit. I'm good. But yeah, it looks solid. It doesn't shake, doesn't vibrate or anything because there are hub-centric rings in there. I didn't really show it, but it's 73.1 to 67.1, just for those who are curious. But yeah, this side is honestly like the ideal fitment. Literally sits perfectly. It's nice. So yeah, next up, probably get the rears and go from there. Solid. Going to be adjusting the wheel fitment and trying to dial it in and get it looking right for the front, and then we're going to throw these wheels on the rear to help me get a good idea of what type of size I'm going to need. These are the fronts. These are 18 by 9.5, and then I have the rear somewhere. They are 19 by 10.5. So the 10.5s are just absolutely too big for the rear, and they poke out extremely way too much, plus they don't clear the strut. So we're gonna be throwing these wheels on the rear just to see how they fit. Basically, I wanna see how 9.5 fits with this offset. And then going from there, I'll see what size I'm gonna need to make fit. Plus, another thing that's wrong with the front is that side over there has a lot more camber than this side. So I'm gonna be adjusting the camber plates and maxing them out. And probably lowering each side, maybe like a half inch or an inch, just to see how that looks. But yeah, besides that, the coilovers have been nice. The wheels have been nice. This thing's been driving amazing. So yeah, this is really simple to take this coilover off. Unfortunately, to get to the camber plate and to adjust it, I do have to end up taking the coilover off just cause like I can't get an Allen wrench up in there. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and take this off and adjust it. Let's get to it. Gone ahead and marked the side that needs to be pushed in. So basically I'm gonna loosen this and then slide this way and then throw it back in. And this is essentially maxing the camber plate out since it's on its furthest setting in. This camber plate is fully maxed out, as you can see. We're just gonna throw this on there and see how it looks. If I need to bring it back a little and maybe take a little camber away, which I hope I don't think I'll need to, but if I need to, then I could do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw it back on. Alright, everything is back together, and as you can see, I mean, it's nearly flush, but it's a whole lot better than before. As you can see, this is what it looks like from here. So yeah, it is a whole lot more flush, so I guess the camber is a whole lot more even compared to that side. As you can see, that looks solid. I might go maybe a little bit lower, maybe like another half inch. Because I don't really want to be low. I'm not finna be scraping and shit once I put the bumper on. Plus bottoming out, I'm cool with all that. So, all right, I'm gonna lower this side again just a little bit more. And then I'm gonna throw these onto the rears just to get a good like guess of how 9.5 is put in the rear. So let's get on it. All right, I'm going ahead and throwing both of the ESRs on this side.
And this fitment, this shit is looking fire. Yeah, that's solid. That's solid. So I guess I have to order another 19 by 9.5. And then with the 265, it'll probably poke out just a little bit more, which is fine. I'll probably be able to adjust the camber arms and lower it. And that should be solid. That's good. Perfect, perfect, perfect spacing. Solid.